Clear a prop.
That's the 615, cost turbulence 5 is over 777, Richmond 5 departure from Charlie, clear takeoff 265.
Check marks, clear takeoff 265, go 615. Tell me like a Hellcat.
Hey guys, what's up? It's James here, and today we are flying Emirates Flight 230 Heavy from Seattle down to, or across to, Dubai. And without further ado, let's get ready here. And we'll ask for boarding. It's going to take a while. Get our plane set up. Get over to the overhead panel. Wow, all my views are buggered. There we go. The ADR sets. Emergency lights. There we go. Boarding is commencing. Left and right path to auto. And we'll pop down to the radios here. And we are in VATSIM today, guys, so we're going to go 122.8. Pop that over into the active frequency. I'm going to squat 2200 for IFR in the US. Pop over to our main panel view here. A little bit messed up the view. Have to recenter it. There we go. Alright, and now let's... Oh, wow, all my views are messed up. That's what happens, I guess. And we're going to go set our FMC up here. We are at Seattle. Enter initial position. Alright. Enter that in there. We're going to request our route, which is Seattle. Let's see if we can find it here to OMDB. Dubai, request it. I got my iPad here with all my flight plan needs. Quickly check PFPX, just a quick check here. Alright. Okay, to the north, lovely. Oh, I hate when that sound cuts out. Anyway, we'll load the uplink here. Doing that, we'll put the flight number in here, Emirates 230 Heavy. And today we're going to check our winds. They're coming from the west. Alright, 200.18, so we're going to have the 16s for departure. Okay, so activate, execute that. Performance, we'll accept it. Flight level 290 is our initial. We got our wind data, so we're going to go legs, route data, load. Execute and descent forecast. Next page, next page. Load. Hello. Okie dokie. Now. We're going back to the initial reference page. We're going to performance. Check everything's good. Let's see if we can derate today. Hopefully we can. Your center. Actually, wait. We have to load. Oop. I'm just going to go like this and use this FMC to load our fuel and payload from the BFPX flight plan. Alright, I got it on my iPad here, so our zero fuel weight is, ooh, very heavy, 204,000 pounds, and then we'll 0.5 in there. I think this is in kilograms. All weights in kilograms. Bugger. Alright, so let me just change it over to pounds. Okay, so I'm gonna enter my weight here. Alright, 204 512. Okay, so 450.8. Zero fuel weights. Oh, bug it. I've messed that up. Okay, so let's do it again. 450.8. Lovely. Quite heavy. Oops, wrong one. And we go to our fuel. And our block fuel today is 123 tons. So 123.394. kilograms. Alright, so we're taking on 272.038. Beautiful. Back to the doors here, we'll close that. Now we can get our weights in here. We'll go to performance again. Request it again, because we have to redo that now. Let's close that up. Okay, we'll accept. 310, we want flight level 290 first, so we're gonna change that. Beautiful. Take off 1. 24%, we're gonna go flaps 15 for departure. And we don't have V speed, so we're gonna have to not select a D rate. Alright, we're gonna select 1/6 left for departure. Departing to the north. Alright, let me get my flight plan in here. Okay. Alright, air nav. Got our departure charts here. Okay, let's see which one we should take. Hello. Okay, now let's see here. I'm gonna select the Elma 2 departure. Works good for us, actually. Let's see. It's our first waypoint. It's Alpsi. Seattle 4. Get back here. Alright, Seattle 4 works. Whoops. Whoops. Bug up. Wrong one. Okay. Now we can go to takeoff. Let's see if we can actually have a D rate. We can! Alright, D rate takeoff 2. There's our trim, and there's our V-speeds, 177, 6.25 units. Okay, so 177. Here, we're taking 1.6 left, so... 1.60. Set 12,000 for now, I'll reset that later on. Auto brakes, RTO! And looks like we have another problem with our brakes. I had that before as well. Whoops. Okay, so if we go to ground maintenance, we'll replace all of these. Beautiful, and then those warnings should go off. Brakes source. Okay, let's double check things here. Failures, active, none, lovely. Service based failures, yep. Maintenance, we're all good. Okay, now, to the checklist, which is not that one, I think it's that one. Yes, it is. Boarding is complete. Oxygen flangements and parking brake. We'll set that. Lovely. And then we'll before start. Okie dokie. Let's start our A cars here.
Welcome aboard, everyone. Before we
there
get
it
moving,
goes.
Please be sure to fasten your seatbelt, return your seat back and folding trays to their full upright position, and store your carry-on luggage in
either Vancouver Center is online. Okay, but he's north of us, so we don't need to worry about him.
Please read carefully the instructions located by the exit. If you do not wish to perform the functions described in them in the event of an emergency, please inform a flight attendant so that they may reseat you. We request that all portable electronic devices, such as mobile phones or laptops, be either turned off or put in airplane mode at this time. This is because these devices may interfere with the aircraft's navigational and communication equipment. We will inform you when you may continue using these devices. We would like to remind you that smoking on board this aircraft is prohibited by law, as is tampering with, disabling, or destroying lavatory smoke detectors. If you have any questions about this flight today, don't hesitate to ask myself or another flight attendant. Have a great flight.
Okay, let's tell the controller what we're up to there. Alrighty. Now, everything's set up, weights are all good. Roger, he says Roger, beautiful. And we can close all of our doors now. So we're going to close the two main doors on the right here, we'll close the cargo doors. We'll arm that main door and arm this one as well. Lovely stuff. Flight director's on. Needles up. Have traffic, weather, and data. Now I'm not going to bother with setting up the other side because they're both synced for some reason. So we don't need to do that. Let's go down here and reset this one. Lovely. Alright, we can request push and start. We're gonna have them let's have nose, right, tail, left. And don't want to start engines before pushback. Good stuff. And we can go ahead and start our APU now. Fuel control switches are all coming on, and the centers as well. Low pressure lights obviously gonna illuminate, but we don't need to worry about that. Let's go down here. But our door closed and locked. Passenger signs. That reminds me. That's why we have checklists. MCP set. Takeoff speed set. CD preflight completed. Trim will hit that after. Taxi and takeoff briefing completed. And then the beacon. Alright, we're going to go to ground connections here. air conditioning we'll get rid of. We have to wait for our APU to be started, and then we can do everything else. All right, let's see that APU is coming up. Once we get the APU running here, sign illuminated. There we go, APU is running, lovely. Now we can disconnect all of our beautiful things. Back to checklist. Lovely. And we shall get rid of the jetway as well. Lovely, he's locking the gear. All good. Once he's done. Release the brakes. Beautiful scenery here, I'll tell you that. Wow.
Thank you.
Got an Alaska in the vicinity. Get that back to zero. 163 is probably going to be our heading. And we'll throw the beacon on now. And we'll start pressurizing the hydraulics. So, right electric, wait for the fault light to extinguish. Status, and then left electric, wait for it to extinguish. Push it as, then we can throw on everything else. Lovely. That's before taxi. Let's go back to the engine page. We will start number two. Oop, there goes the night lighting. Okay. Throw the fuel in now. Turn outside view and watch it spool. That's good. Set the brakes. There we go. All the lights flashed. All right, and let's start number one.
I'm locking gear.
Fuel in right away.
Nose wheel steering connected. Pins removed. Tow vehicle disconnected.
Front on the TCAS now. Or the transponder, sorry. Otherwise known as TCAS. Lovely stuff. There we go, we can hear number one spooling. Up it comes.
Clear behind the aircraft, left and right.
Lovely, we're clear, good stuff. FMC here, the legs, vectors, the level 280. I'm just gonna go ahead and set that up to 290 now. Lovely! Alright, engine stable. Flaps 15. Alright, and four taxi checklist. Anti-ice, good. Recalls, good. Flight controls and ground equipment. Alright, and then that will be all by itself there. Alright, so let's go flight controls. Alright, full up. Full down. Center. Ailerons, full left. Down the right, full right. Down the left. Beautiful center. Rudder, full left. Full right. And center. Lovely, we're all good there. Gear page. Good. Door page, all armed. Fuel running off the center tanks. Good stuff. APU is still running. Back to engines. And now the engine arm, we get the APU off. And runway turn off and taxi's coming on. Ooh, what was that lag? Anyways, it's gone now. Alright. Sound's gonna cut out, sorry guys. Okay. Alright, wind's 200 at 18, gusting to 26. I'm gonna go over to the ATIS now. Ooh. Get that a good checking too. And we'll monitor. You can see.
Kilo, Sierra, Echo, Alpha, airport information. Charlie, 1453, Zulu, weather, wind, 185 at 18, gusting 229, visibility, 10, sky condition, ceiling, 4,500, broken, ceiling, 6,000, overcast, temperature, 11, dew point, 3, altimeter, 2964. Advise on initial contact, you have information. Charlie, Kilo, Sierra, Echo, Alpha.
Alright, good, just as I expected. Go to the outside view, show you guys flight controls. There we go. The engine side. Good stuff. Okay. Get the brakes off. And we can start rolling. Add a little bit of power here since we're so heavy. Alrighty. We're rolling. Reminds me. Let's get our dynamic head movement.
If I could get everyone's attention,
running.
We will now review safety information regarding the flight today. When you see the seatbelt sign illuminate, you must fasten your seatbelt. Insert the metal fitting, one into the other, and tighten by pulling on the loose end of the strap. You can release your seatbelt by lifting the upper portion
of
the
clear button. Left.
It's preferred that you keep your seatbelt
clear right.
Throughout the flight in case of turbulence.
Right turn.
There are several emergency exits throughout the take a moment to locate your closest exit. Some cases, your
nearest laggy. Well, that's fine. Cabin's ready. Good stuff.
Floor level lighting will guide you toward the available exit. Doors can be opened by moving the handle in the direction of the arrow. Each door is equipped with an inflatable slide which can be detached and used as a life raft.
Beautiful.
Oxygen and air pressure are always monitored throughout the flight. If decompression occurs, an oxygen mask will fall from the ceiling in front of you.
Reset the view real quick.
Now
we'll begin the long taxi to 16 left.
Terminal
looks really nice.
Top of your head and your elbows against your thighs. Ensure your feet are flat on the floor. Flight vests are located in a pouch under your seat between the armrests. When instructed to do so, open the plastic pouch and remove the vest. Flip it over your head and bring the straps around your waist. Adjust the straps with the front.
Faster, pull back on the power.
Electronic devices like phones and laptop computers may be used only when the seatbelt sign is off and when permitted by the crew. Mobile phones must remain off throughout the flight. Remember that this is a non-smoking flight. Also, damaging the smoke detectors in the lavatories is prohibited by law. You will find all safety information in the card located in the cockpit in front of you. It is recommended that you read it before we take off. If you have any questions, please ask myself or another crew member. We hope you enjoy your flight.
Alright. We're all set up for the departure. Let's get lined up on the runway here and we'll get going. Start the clock now. Good. All lined up. View's all good. Centered, sort of. Yeah, it's good. Alright. Get ready here. It's roughly 50%. They're all stable. I'm gonna select Toga. Let's go. rudder. It's very gusty, so we're gonna get some bumps. 23 knots, there we go. Stuff. Airborne. There's a southwest. Positive rate gear coming up. There's the bumps I was talking about. Flying manually here. I'm not being armed. If I can click them. Go to the legs page, vectors direct Alpsy. I'm just gonna climb up high enough, and we'll go direct Alpsy. There's the G meter, look at that, bloody hell. Push down slightly for reduce in power, or reduction in power. Have a look outside, wow, very nice. Turn here. Direct Alpsy. Throw the autopilot on this turn. Flaps coming to 5. She starts to climb. There we go. Just gotta select the altitude. Lovely. Select 40 right there. Look out the wing there, there's Seattle. Taking off into the night does look rather frickin' brilliant. Alrighty, we'll go back to the checklist page here. Hangers up, flaps up, and next checklist is descent. Lovely. Oops, that was bad. Let's get over here and skip over to the air page. There it is. Passenger signs are good auto now. And I'm just going to throw off the lights now. Alright. Well, that's pretty much it. We just climb up for the rest of this little bit, guys. So, I will do a little time lapse and talk to you guys later. Hi guys, we're back. It's just getting bloody dark again. It was day the whole bloody flight. And now we're stuck with nighttime conditions once again, which is ever so lovely. But we have to program in. Reset that again. Our bloody arrival. So, go to the departure arrival page. It's already set on here. We are landing on runway 30 left. Winds right now, currently, are 310 at 12 knots, and they're variable from 280 degrees to 340 degrees. So, that gives us runway, and it's 1013 in the QNH. And our last waypoint on our flight plan in PFBX is Desti, or if I pronounce it correct. So we're going to take the only available arrival from Desti, so with the Desti 8 Charlie arrival. To execute that, hopefully Dubai approach stays online. Probably won't. Hopefully it does. I should have bloody know. And we're gonna quickly get to our descent page. Get our descent winds, as they're probably going to be changed after 12 hours and 50 minutes of flying. So we'll just wait for that. I hate when I click on something else, the sound bloody cuts out. Anyways, let's load that. And, I don't know, they haven't really changed. Interesting, whatever. Alright. We'll get our transition set in after. Let's get to... checklist. And... camera here. So, recall. Let's check. Crafted that on the takeoff, but it's fine. Notes, charts, and everything. Auto brake. We're going to select auto brake 2 for the landing. VREF minimums. We'll get those in during the descent. And then the approach briefing we'll also get during the descent. Come to the air page. We get our VNAV data here. Top of descent is 174 nautical miles, so we got a little ways to go. Oops. So, once we hit top of descent, we start descending. I will check back in with you guys, but for now, enjoy the view. Okay guys, just about to hit top of descent. We're gonna reset our MCP altitude down to 6,000 or above. This is no ATC on. They have logged off. Pretty much buggered. Anyways, forecast good, and I found the flight level transition. It's flight level 150, and we're in hectopascals now. And the decision height is they're using a radio altimeter of 100 feet above ground level. Ahead and set that in there. There we go, there's descent. It's going to take forever to get the radio altimeter all the way down there. Video 100. Bloody good that is. Alright, economy descent. Speeds are all good. hop down there. Good plan. Gonna watch for our arrival here. So it's pretty much there. Left right turn. And pretty much flying the downwind all the way out there. And then a turn in for final. And since there's no ATC, we'll just fly the whole thing and slow down on the way. Because normally ATC would probably give us a vector in earlier. But since they bloody left, we're bugging. So, we need to back up again, get our weather radar back on. Data's still good, and for the traffic on once again. Our 200% page. Oh, that reminds me. Flaps 30, 141 BREF. Lovely stuff. That checklist once more. Let's pop over here. Land data VRF minimums all checked. Approach briefing is completed. And then on the approach, we'll set the altimeters. For now, back to the air page. We stop still on 122.8. Lovely. And I'll check back in with you guys further on in the descent. Alright guys, I'm back with you here. Just grabbing, oopsie daisy, my charts on the iPad. Oh, wait a minute. I should know. I'm landing on the right runway. Okay, good. But I was landing on the wrong. Runway for a second there, but yeah, I'm good. I am all good. Okie dokie. Our descent path went a little bit out of whack, but we seem to have caught back onto it now. I got some cloud ahead. We're going to be approaching the coast any minute now. You can see it in the distance there, just a little bit. Alright, 6,000 or above. That's for the next one. Apparently we're going to be at 11,000 for this whole little bit here. That's interesting. Let's see if we can actually cut down on that. Because we just want 6,000 or above. So from... let's give us a couple more miles. Alright, so from Velar... Velar, then it would be the Dubai 509 and whatnot. Okay, so Velar, cut it off at right here, bull dots, because those are just extenders, really. Let's see. There we bloody go. That cuts it off very nicely. Now it just goes. Here we go, Velar, whole lot, and then for the final approach course. Lovely stuff. So now we're just going to be descending a little bit more. Where's Wanasa? 2,000 or above. So we're going to get her down to 2,000. There we go. Pressure reference is still the same. Now it's still good. There's Dubai, lovely. Still no ATC. We got some traffic, but Speedbird. Don't know where he's at. We're gonna announce to him. Okay, sorry for the sound cutting out, guys.
Feet.
Yep, there he goes. It's 4. Okay, now we've hit 10,000. And it's bloody nighttime. We We can throw on the lights and the logo, and look at the taxi while we're thinking about it. Okay, charts close there. We don't need that until we're down. Early morning here in Canada. It's a bloody 7:30 in the morning. Wow. Only for the sim. Look at bloody Fly Tampa Dubai. There's the aerodrome right there, the Airport. We got Dubai City over there, the world's tallest building. Right bloody there. Good stuff. Center of the view right there. Perfect. Cut down on the view here. This thing is descending way too bloody slow. Take it over manually. Now I'm going to slow to 210 just so we can drop her down some more. Ooh. 1800 feet per minute. Throw the seatbelt signs fully on. They're already on, but just double check them in there. Get our ground connections ready. Get our ground connection page ready. So we can do that ever so bloody quickly. We shall check Dubai ATIS. As so.
Oscar, Mike, Sierra, Juliet, airport information, Delta 1.
That's the wrong bloody one. If that does it. Wrong bloody one again. There we go.
Oscar, Mike, Delta, Bravo, airport
there
information, Echo, 1400, Zulu, weather, wind, 308, at 12, visibility, 10, sky condition, few clouds at 4,500, temperature, 24, 2.18, QNH, 1013, advise on initial contact that you have information, Echo. Oscar, Mike, Delta, Bravo, airport information, Echo,
1013. Lovely stuff. I'm just going to throw out the spoilers here. The speed brakes, whatever you'd like to call them. Just give ourselves some drag. Get down to altitude in time. Slowly incinerate as well. We're going to get our set to 180, because that's our intercept speed. There we go. Bloody hell. Looks lovely. My god, this 777's awesome. Love this bloody plane. And for when we land, head over here. Arrival gate is going to be Foxtrot. 13. Foxtrot 13 for the arrival. Ooh, we can really slow our descent now. So we passed the, apparently, we passed the thing. Anyway, I'm just gonna hold 3,000 for this initial one here. Just because, really, we don't need to be so low until these are on. What's that? Vortex is coming off the wingtips. We're gonna wait for this descent thingy to come back in there. Double check something at. Is it Velar or Uldot? Uldot, 3,000. It's pretty much 3,500 anyway, so. We don't need it anyway. Interesting. Alright, anyways, back to there. Black's coming to one. flaps coming to 5. Hold at 200. Just for now, keep it in turn. These flaps take time to come out. Oh, bloody hell, Precip FX is working. It hasn't loaded in yet. Oh, black, 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 more black. Ugliness. There we go. Sort of. Yeah, there we go. Oh. Now it's gone. Bastards. Anyways. Now we can slow to 180. Doing so, we're gonna go flaps 15. So we're gonna go back to the wing view and watch those come out. Make them look bloody. Oops. Okay, coffee there. Look at that. Oh, yes. Oh, bloody yes. This view likes to move on me a bit. Easy Dock is being tricky. Very tricky. Now we can go down to 3,000. Well, down you go, down you go. Okay, we shall force you down. Good stuff. Let's minimize the view there. Okay. Final localizer. Passing through it now. Resets our heading as well. Good bloody stuff. I don't know what those glitches with the scenery are, but... well, we won't be bothered about them too much.
2,500.
There we go, there's the altitude warning. Come back on the localizer here, holding 3,000 still. Cabin is ready. Lovely stuff. Alright, here comes the localizer. Now we can, once we catch that arm approach, slightly bumpy, not too bad. Slowly coming back onto it. Bloody slowly coming back onto it. This radio altimeter coming back in again. Late left turn. I'm pretty much on it. Oops, that's arm approach. And here comes the glide slope. Slow to 170. Actually, back to 160. Get flaps 25. Oh, sorry, 20. And then 25 would be just after that. Bloody hell, I fly so many aircraft I forget the flap configuration sometimes. And this one I only fly on long hauls, really. Here comes the glide slope, slowing to 151. 10 above the VREF. Flaps 25 now. Gear down. Oh. Right when the warning config thing comes on. Anyways, it's coming down. Transition.
2,500.
Alright, gear down 3 green. Flaps 30. To the checklist. Altimeter set. Speed right armed. Landing checklist complete. The engines. Gears checked, doors are all open. Recall. Checked. We are configured for landing. We are stable. Announce unfastening real quick. Bloody sound's gonna cut out again. There we go. Now, quick little wing view for you all. Speed's perfect. Right on the money. Looking ever so lovely. And we're centered in our seats, sort of, moving around a bit, but it's fine. Okay. Autopilot's coming off. It is off. Oop. A little bit of a lag there. Coming back on the localizer. Good stuff. Right again. For the nose down pitch. Auto throttle's handling everything for me. Back to 150. That one knot makes a difference. Still on the glide slope, a little bit low. Localizer centered. Move the highway. A little bit high now. Still fine though. Fully visual now.
Approaching minimums.
Minimums is coming up. We have the runway made and in sight, so we're all good. Continue.
30, 20.
And the flare. A little left rudder here. Oh, that was a lag. Bloody Nora. And reverse. Brakes are working. And reverse out. Manual braking. Tell you one thing, that bloody glitch on touchdown was weird. But nevertheless, we can deal with that. Brakes are disarmed. Water brakes off. Looking good. A little bit of right to the center line, or right of the center line there, but other than that, not too bad. Alright, we can stop the clock now. 13 hours and 40 minutes flight time. Bloody hell. Alright, lights off first. Turn us on, and strobes are off. Heels off. Weather, data, and traffic is off. Alright, clean up. Suppose ejected, flaps up. Beautiful. And flight directors are off now. Now, let's see if it wants to comply. Oh. Why are the bloody Foxtrot gates too small? Why? Do not under bloody stand. Oh, no. Nope, I almost clicked on me. Okay, let me just stop here for a second. Okay, that's obviously broken. Okay, let's try Foxtrots are working. Actually, yeah, that is a smaller terminal. Okay, we want Foxtrot 18 or higher then. Directly in front of us is Foxtrot 18, 19. We'll take 18. We got Emirates. Oh, and of course, it's bloody buggered. Thank you, GSX. Come on, reinitialize. There you go. There you bloody go. Oh my god. Bloody GSX, I tell ya. I tell ya what. It's not really gonna comply with me, I don't think. Bloody hell. Nope. Still not working. Okay, we're gonna stop here. Just for a second. While I think about it. APU, you can bloody come on now. Jesus Christ, why is it not working? I don't understand that. Okay, let's try Concourse Alpha. Alpha doesn't matter. Doesn't matter which one it is. Alpha, let's go. This is Concourse Alpha right here. Let's go Alpha 5. Nope, still buggered. Okay, why are only some of the bloody gates working? Doesn't make much sense at all. Literally makes no sense. Okay, let's try this. Okay, whenever I request Emirates, it's not going to work. Interesting. Let's try something other than Emirates then. DN80. No, it's still buggered. Anyways. Let's just give up on that bastard. The gates that don't accept heavy aircraft worked, but these ones do not for some reason. Interesting. YOLO, we'll take Alpha 4. Right bloody here. Lights off here. Whoa, that was bloody awful. When this view moves, I tell you what. So bloody confusing. I don't know, if anybody knows how to fix that from, like, whenever I turn the aircraft and the view slowly moves left or right, I would love to know, because it doesn't do it on my NGX. It only does it on this bastard. See if it actually tells us when to stop. I doubt it. I really do doubt it. Oh no! It's actually bloody telling us. It tells us distance, but it doesn't tell us much other things. Recenter that. There we go. Lovely. Engines can come off now. And seatbelts. Hydraulics depressurizing. Better wing view, watch those fall. Should depressurize any second now. There we go. Okay. Conditioning. All right. Now it's working. Going to be interesting. See if GSX works now. Once we request bloody deboarding. Emirates? Nope, still broken. Anyways, I don't know, it just. Some series it just bloody crashes, and, well, this happens to be one of them, unfortunately. Might as well open the doors. Kind of pointless, but might as well. And we'll check our 8 cars here. Beautiful. Finish it. File the pyrep. Oh, and last thing to get done. Lights are all good. Lovely. And the emergency lights can come off. And as can the APU. Checklist, we'll go over there. Shut down hydraulics, good. Fuel pumps off, and then parking brake. Last thing is the fuel pumps. And we're pretty much good to go. Secure, ADRU, and the packs. Might as well secure the aircraft since we're not flying anywhere after. So, ADRU. And packs can come off. Back to our pre-flight. Engine, and then off. Okay. Still on Vasson. We got some air traffic. Pops the outside view here. GSX is buggered. But other than that, the flight went lovely. I love this bloody livery for Emirates. Look at it. Real Madrid. And who doesn't like Real bloody Madrid? Wow. So nice. The only bloody problem with the scenery is the bloody jetways are static. The bastards. Alright, let's double check here. There's me that's arrived. The BA is departing for Heathrow. There's Emirates coming from Munich, who's arriving. He should be somewhere over there. Where's that BA? He's got the scenery. He's at Foxtrot 6. But he's still at the bloody gate. I'm way over on the bloody other side of the airport. see what's in the terminal. Bloody nothing in this one. Interesting. Anywho, I hope you don't hear that train. You probably can, though. Frickin' thing. Bloody loud it is. Bloody loud. Anyways, well, I hope you boys, guys, not just boys, could be girls too, bloody hell. I hope you all enjoyed the flight. Give it a like if you liked it. Follow, or no, it's not follow, I'm thinking about Twitch, my god, YouTube. And subscribe if you liked it as well. I hope to get some aviation videos done this summer in Cessna 152s, blah blah, etc. So I need to get some funding for some GoPros. I hope to set up some sort of aviation channel donation program for the GoPros. I hope to get at least two. I just got my David Clark headset in, the 13.4. And I put that on my Instagram because it's just bloody cool. And I got an adapter as well for the GoPros, so you'll be able to hear the sound. But the GoPros, I need a little bit of help budgeting for that, because I don't make $400 a month, unfortunately. Part-time jobs, they suck. So yeah, everything helps. And also, things for the sim as well. Hope to get a streaming PC separate to the actual PC, so I can get more things done. But this is all stuff that's happening in the future. Until then, happy flying. And always remember, keep the airspeed alive. See you guys.